Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Fantastic Math. In last video we learned what is division. Now in this video we are going to learn few keywords which we use in division. Second, I will tell you one activity which will help you to understand the division. And third, we will learn division method, means how to do division. So don't miss any concept and watch this video till end. So let's start. First, we will start with the keywords. Here keywords are dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. Let's understand these keywords with the help of an example. So here I have 12 chocolates which I want to distribute equally among 3 children. So how can we write it in division? We have total 12 chocolates, right? And we want to distribute it equally among 3 children. So we will write 12 divided by 3. We have total 12 chocolates. So this total number of chocolates called dividend. Means dividend is the number or amount which we want to divide. And we want to divide these chocolates among 3 children. So this 3 is the divisor. Means divisor is the number that divide another number. Here 3 is dividing 12, right? So this is called divisor. And what is the answer of 12 divided by 3? 3 times what number gives 12? 3 times 4 gives 12, right? So our answer is 4. So answer called quotient. We can write this division like this also. Means left side of this symbol will come divisor, right side dividend will come and answer will be at the top, which is called quotient. Now let's revise it again. Dividend. Dividend is the number to be divided into groups. Second, divisor. Divisor is the number that divide another number. Third is quotient. Quotient is the answer in division. Remainder we will understand with another example. So here I have 12 chocolates. At this time I want to distribute these chocolates equally among 5 children. Means we want to make 5 groups, right? So let's distribute. So this is first group, then second group, then third group, then fourth group, then fifth group. And now 2 chocolates are left, right? And we can't distribute these 2 chocolates among 5 children. So this is called leftover chocolate, right? So remainder is leftover number. So here remainder is 2. And most important thing which you have to remember is the remainder is always be smaller than the divisor. Here remainder is 2 and divisor is 5, right? So 2 is less than 5, means remainder is less than 5. So our remainder is correct. Now let's move to the activity. For this activity you need 30 rajma seeds and then you have to put them into equal groups. Then find out how many groups are there and how many are left over. Here table is given, so according to the table you can find out the answer. Link of this activity sheet and worksheet is given in the description box, so you can check it there. Now let's move to the division method. So here question is 48 divided by 3. So first we will write it in this form and we will solve it step by step. So in first step we will compare. We will compare the first digit of dividend with the divisor. So here first digit of the dividend is 4, that is greater than 3, right? So we will go to the step number 2. In step number 2 we will divide. So we will check the 3's table. So 3 ones are 3 and 3 twos are 6, but here 6 is greater than 4, right? So we can't take 6. We will go with the 3, and 3 times 1 gives 3, right? So 1 will come here, and then we will go to step number 3. In step number 3, we multiply. We multiply this quotient with the divisor. So 3 ones are 3. So we write 3 here. And then we will go to step number 4. In step number 4, we subtract it. So here we will subtract. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Then we will go to step number 5. In step number 5, we will bring down the next digit of the dividend. So here next digit is 8. So we will bring it down here. Now the number is 18. Now we will follow the same steps from step number 1. So in step number 1, first we will compare. So 18 is greater than 3. So we can go to the second step. In second step, we will divide it. So 3 times which number gives 18? 3 times 6 gives 18, right? So we write 6 here and then we will go to step number 3. In step number 3, we multiply quotient with divisor. So 6 times 3 gives 18. So we write 18 here and then we will subtract it. So 18 minus 18 is equal to 0. Now we don't have any other digit in dividend. So our answer is 16. Now let's check our answer is correct or not. For checking the answer, we have one formula. In this formula, we will multiply quotient with divisor and then we will add the answer with the remainder. And if the answer is equal to the dividend, then our answer is correct. Let's check it. Here quotient is 16. So we will write 16 here. Then we will multiply it with the divisor. So here divisor is 3, right? So we will multiply it. 16 multiplied by 3 gives 48, right? And our remainder is 0. So we will add this answer with the remainder. That will give us 48. Now this is equal to the dividend because dividend is 48. So our answer is correct. With the help of this method, you can divide any 2-digit number by 1-digit number. In next video, we will learn how to divide 3-digit numbers by 1-digit number. Now, I hope you like this video. If you like this video, then please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so you will get the notification of my next video. Thank you.